Hello, dear learners. Very good evening to you. Welcome back. So my next tutorial is range function and for loop. We will study about it in this tutorial. Range function. So first of all, we should know about the range function. Okay, what is it? As we know, range is a sequence. Okay, so it is a built-in function in Python. It is used to create a list containing a sequence of numbers starting with the start and ending with 1 less than the stop. Okay, if I have 11, so it will end till 10. Clear? So let's see, its syntax is range start comma stop, whatever you, the number from where you want to start and where you want to stop. Clear? Next is the start and step parameters. Start and step parameters are optional one. Okay, the list starts from 0 and in every iteration it is incremented by 1, but we can specify a different increment value by using step parameter. Range is often used in for loops. Clear? So let's see the examples here. I have written here few commands and their outputs, respective outputs. Like if I have written like this, range 10, okay, so it will display from 0 to 9, that I already told you, ending with 1 less than the stop. Okay, if I have mentioned here start and also given the stop value, so means it will start from 1 to and it will end 1 less than the stop, that is 10. Clear? So this is how, like 0 minus 9 and it is saying minus 1. So their difference would be of minus 1 between each number. Clear? Like here range 0, 30 and 5. So here difference between each number, here the difference between each number, okay, that will be of 5. Okay, that will be of this 5. Okay, so it will start from 0. Then add on 5, then 5, again add on 5, again add off, and less than 5, then the stop number. Clear? So this is what the range function. Clear? So guys, let's see, create a new file and let's understand the range function first. Range function, I will use for loop with range, range function I. Okay, in range, that is suppose I am writing here 5, fine, and now after that I have to print, fine, what I have to print here, that is suppose hello Python, hello Python, fine. If I will save this and let's save and see the output, range, okay, fine. Okay, so let's run this. Okay, you can see here I have written till 5. So let's do the counting. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is printing hello Python till 5. Fine. So let's see again one more example here for this. Let's create a new file again. Fine. I am again writing the range function. Fine, and use for I, okay, in range 5, okay, in range 6, let's take 6 and print I multiply by 5, okay, I multiply by 5. So let's save it. Range 2, okay, and run it. So you can see here I am just having the value from I 6, then it is multiplying the number with the 6. Okay, here suppose it is 0, okay, it is starting from 0, so it will multiply 0 multiply by 6, 0 here, okay, and if next it will increase the number, okay, and then it will come here 1, then again 6, then 2, 12, so you can see so on, the number that is printed over here. Okay, so this is how the range function works. So let's move forward for the for loop. Okay, so let's understand now for loop. What is it? The for statement is used to iterate or repeat itself over a range of values or a sequence. Clear? So the for loop is executed for each items in a range. Clear? The for loop is executed, I'm repeating it again, the for loop is executed for each of these items in the range. Fine. Next is, with every iteration of the loop, the control variable checks whether each of the values in the range has been traversed or not. When all the items in the range are exhausted, the body of the loop is not executed anymore. Clear? The control is then transferred to the statement immediately following for the for loop. So let's see, here I have the syntax also, for loop, okay, for, then control variable, whatever it can be, I, J, K, L, N, whatever the variable you want to take. Then in function, okay, in keyword and sequence of items in a range. Then after that the block, the print, whatever you want to print. And this else is optional one. Clear? So this is the flowchart. It is saying initializing the statement. Fine. If the expression is here, okay, it will go to the test expression. Fine. If it is true, so it will execute the body for the loop, okay, whatever is written here in as a statement. Then it will update the statement, means it will increment it by 1, 2, whatever you have written over there. Then again it will come here. If it is true, then again it will be executed, okay, till the last number. Fine. Suppose if it is false, now we have just talked about the true one. If the result test expression becomes false, so what will happen? It will immediately exit the for loop and it will jump to the statement just below the while loop. Clear? Just below the for loop. Fine. So let's write in, let's create one more file. Okay, let's create one more file. So here we will generate a table of a number. Okay, so I'm writing here table of a number. Fine. So how to do that? Let's see. I am simply just assigning the value, that is number is equal to, you can say whatever the table you want to write here, for. Okay, then I will write for and the control variable, okay, I, in range till where you want the table, that is it should start from 1 and it should go till 11. Fine. That means it will print till less than the 1, okay, less than this step number. Clear? And after that simply close it and then print what I have to print here, print number. Fine. X, okay, x, then it's multiply, sorry, okay, multiply with whom I have to multiply it, with I value, whatever the next I value is here, I, okay. And after that I have to print is equal to, fine, is equal to simple table. Clear? And after that I have to write here number multiply by I. Fine. So clear? I hope I have written it, number multiply by I is equal to number multiply by I. Fine. So let's save it with table. Okay, let's save it with table. So let me run it again. So let's see. Oh, okay, multiply with I, it's showing only I. So here if the value is I, okay, then what will happen? 4 multiply by 1, okay, it should be 4, 8, 12, 4, table of 4 is here. Okay, so here, fine. Just a minute, my program is here only. Number is equal to 4. Fine. For I in range 1, yes, this, and then number print number clear a multiply, is it multiply sign? Is it okay? Let's just simply run it. Again, it is showing I only. Why it is not showing me the value? I have to see once. So what was the problem here? I just simply written here this I in single quotes. So that's why it was showing here multiply 4 multiply by I, 4 multiply by I. Okay. I hope you have understood how to do this. Okay. It's very simple. If I will simply change the number here, if I will write here 5, anything. Okay. Simply I will run here. It will show me the table of 5 here. Wow, it's very great, huh? It is looking very good. You know, the range function used in the above program will generate values as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I is the loop control variable and will be assigned. See, I is the loop variable and will be assigned. This I, okay? Loop variable, loop control variable, and will be assigned each generated value. Okay, for which the body for loop will be executed here. Okay, I hope you have understood. So, thank you. So, there are a few points that we have to keep in mind while writing the for loop with range function. The for loop in Python is used to iterate values from range of values, string, list, tuples or dictionary. Else statement is optional here and will be executed after all the iterations of for loop are over. Repeated execution of a set of statements is called iteration. The loop variable contains the highest value of the list after for loop is over. The value of for loop variable can't be defined beforehand. Okay, thank you. Just keep these points in your mind while using the for loop with range function. Thank you guys. If you like my video, please subscribe and keep visiting my channel for new updates. Thank you.